Chapter 9. Assessment of Entrepreneurial Opportunities. Since the mid-1990s, more than 600,000 new firms have emerged in the United States every year. That works out to about 1,500 business startups per day. Additionally, the U.S. Patent Office currently reviews more than 375,000 patent applications per year. It's clear, in light of these statistics, that many people have ideas for new ventures. But what percentage of these startups achieves success? And what makes for a successful new venture? In this chapter, we'll look at answers to these questions. Entrepreneurs start new ventures for a variety of reasons. One study identified these seven components of new venture motivation: the need for approval, the need for independence, the need for personal development, welfare considerations, perception of wealth, tax reduction and indirect benefits, and following role models. While entrepreneurs start new ventures for a variety of reasons, these entrepreneurial motivations usually relate to the personal characteristics of the entrepreneur, the environment, and the venture itself. The variables in the new venture idea creation and startup process are many. This creates a challenge for researchers attempting to identify predictors of success or failure. One researcher identified a series of challenges to predicting new firm performance, including the entrepreneur's personal goals and their process of founding the business, the business environment for the venture, including the risks, markets, and resources available, and the unique nature of the venture itself. So how does an entrepreneur know which idea to pursue? The decision to focus on an idea and develop a venture is critical in new venture development. These six pitfalls in the process of selecting new ventures can lead to an untimely end: a tendency to fall in love with an idea and not give it a thorough and objective evaluation; a failure to fully understand the market; a failure to anticipate technical difficulties in developing or producing a new product; over-optimistic estimates of the funds required to bring the product to market; a lack of uniqueness, special characteristics, and design concepts that draw customers and provide superior performance or service; or a failure to know and understand legal requirements. A new venture progresses through three phases. The pre-startup phase begins with an idea for the venture and ends when the doors are open for business. The startup phase begins with sales activity and the delivery of products and services, and ends when the business is firmly established. The post-startup phase lasts until the entrepreneur exits the business or the venture is terminated. The pre-startup and startup phases are the most critical for entrepreneurs. During these phases, five factors are critical: the relative uniqueness of the venture, the investment required at startup, the expected sales growth, the availability of products, and the availability of customers. A number of critical factors are important for new venture assessment. This idea checklist lists key questions to consider in the following categories: basic feasibility of the venture, competitive advantages of the venture, buyer decisions in the venture, marketing of the goods and services, production of the goods and services, staffing decisions, control of the venture, and production of the goods and services, staffing decisions, control of the venture, and think back to the statistics quoted at the beginning of the chapter. Every year, millions of dollars are spent starting new ventures. Many of these businesses vanish within a year or two. Only a small percentage achieve success. Researchers examined 250 high-tech firms and found that causes for failure fell within three major categories: product market problems, financial difficulties, and managerial problems. Product market problems relate to timing, product design, distribution strategy, unclear business definition, and an over-reliance on one customer. Financial difficulties included initial undercapitalization, debt, and venture capital relationship problems. Managerial problems dealt with hiring practices, poor external relationships, incompetent support from professionals, and a focus on the development of weaknesses rather than strengths. Additionally, the study identified problems related to owner ego, employee concerns, control issues, and interpersonal problems. A study of successful ventures, defined as firms listed in the Inc. 500 group of fastest-growing privately held companies, systematically categorized the most significant problems encountered at startup, listed here. Another study of 645 entrepreneurs focused on the classification of startup and growth problems experienced internally versus externally. The external problems encountered most often related to customer contact, market knowledge, market planning, and location. The internal problems encountered most often in the startup and growth phases included adequate capital, cash flow, facilities equipment, and inventory control. Another study examined the differing perceptions of new venture failing among entrepreneurs and venture capitalists. The results, shown here, indicate that entrepreneurs attributed new venture failure to internal factors 89% of the time. Venture capitalists also tended to attribute failure to internal causes. A fourth failure study proposed a failure prediction model based on financial data from new ventures. These findings indicate that entrepreneurs should be sure that the venture is able to yield positive profitability and cash flows in the first years. Be sure the initial balance sheet reflects stockholders' capital sufficient to offset future losses. Ensure positive cash flows in the early years. Limit the size of the venture when the initial balance sheet indicates probability of negative cash flows and a larger debt share. Not budget for fast velocity of capital in the initial years if the risk of negative cash flows is high. And monitor financial ratios from the first year, especially the cash flow to total debt ratio. Pay special attention to keeping profitability at the planned level. The risk of failure for new firms can be reduced by using less debt as initial financing and by generating enough revenue in the initial stages. The study also identified the risk associated with the initial size of the venture being developed. Solid analysis and evaluation of the feasibility of an idea for a new product or service is critical to success. This rigorous evaluation process will reveal fatal flaws and help refine the new venture concept. A profile analysis approach allows entrepreneurs to identify major strengths and weaknesses in the financial, marketing, organizational, and human resource factors needed for the venture to progress successfully. A feasibility criteria approach is based on a criteria selection list from which entrepreneurs can gain insights into the viability of their ventures. A third approach, the comprehensive feasibility approach, incorporates external factors in addition to those in the criteria questions. This approach is the most comprehensive and systematic feasibility analysis. The feasibility criteria approach was developed to help entrepreneurs assess the viability of their ventures. This criteria selection list is based on the following questions. Is it proprietary? Are the initial production costs realistic? Are the initial marketing costs realistic? Does the product have potential for very high margins? Is the time required to get to market and to reach the break-even point realistic? Is the potential market large? Is the product the first of a growing family? Does an initial customer exist? Are the development costs in calendar times realistic? Is this a growing industry? And can the product and the need for it be understood by the financial community? A comprehensive feasibility approach is a more comprehensive and systematic feasibility analysis for a new venture. The approach includes external as well as internal factors. This figure shows a breakdown of the factors involved in a comprehensive feasibility study: technical, market, financial, organizational, and competitive. An objective and in-depth study of a new venture based on the criteria outlined in this chapter won't guarantee success, but it will certainly increase your chances. A more detailed feasibility analysis guide identifying the specific activities involved in each feasibility area is provided here.